इकोनॉमिक जूलॉजी पार्ट इट इज ओवरलैपिंग टू योर जी एस. ओके, बिकॉज सी वेन यू लर्न अबाउट दी जी एस अबाउट दी लाइक रिसेंट ऑन गोइंग. हेलो, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर शिवानी शर्मा. टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट ऑन द टॉपिक लाइक हाउ यू आर प्रिपेयर फॉर जूलॉजी ऑप्शन. ओके, सो आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू सम टिप एंड ट्रिक्स दैट आई होप दिस विल गोइंग टू बी बेनिफिशियल फॉर यू. ओके, सो आई कंसीडर ऑल ऑफ यू एज अ फ्रेशर एंड आई थिंक लाइक दैट यू डू नॉट नो अबाउट एनी थिंग अबाउट योर जूलॉजी एज एन ऑप्शनल. ओके, एंड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो वी आर ऑल्सो गोइंग टू टॉक about on this thing which topics are very important for scoring more in your particular topic. Okay, I am not saying that this thing like some topic are not important. The point is that like you have to do smart study. Okay, you have to do more focus on those particular area which is very very important as the point of view of your examination. Okay, the first thing before starting any optional, the thing you should keep in your mind, you have to do or you have to make a consistency throughout your journey. Because if you drop out your consistency, then you will not going to achieve your goal. Okay, and this is a fact now. Before you have to achieve anything, so you just have to fix your goal. Now you decided that you will going to be a UPSC aspirant, so yes, now you will have to give your 100% potential on your subject. Clear? And to now you choose your geology as an option. So see what you have to do. First, just take out the printout of your syllabus and paste it on your study paper. Okay, so whenever you see the syllabus, you should keep this thing in your mind, like you have to complete this syllabus within this time limit. Okay, and the next second thing what you have to do, just take out the PYQ for the last 10 years. Why I am saying so, you have to take out all the PYQs, because once you see PYQ, you just feel very confident. The question was very easy, and also one thing you going to be noticed, the question was overlapped to each other. As I always mentioned in my videos, the plus point with our subject is that our subject is very constant and it is not going to be changed. Whatever the syllabus has been designed by the UPSC, it will fixed only. Okay, the question asked from the syllabus only. Yes, we have some topics from the ecology and the economic part. Yes, they will ask something extra from this particular part according to the recent going on technology or according to the recent going on pollution act etc. Okay, but do not worry about it, because you learned this thing from your GS subject. Okay, and the very important fact with your subject is that like your subject is related to your GS subject. Okay, because somehow they related with there. Okay, so ye aapki kuch plus points hai that zoology is good for you. Okay, so let's start with the zoology. So see, if we see the pattern, so your zoology have a zoology option have two paper. Okay, the paper first and the next you have paper two. Okay, and in paper one you have conventional zoology. In paper what you have, in paper you have conventional zoology and in paper 2 you have modern zoology. Now there is an interesting point. Now some of you found out that paper first is easy and some of you found out that paper 2 is easy according to your background. If you belongs to the background like medical and you belongs to the background like biotech, pharma, nursing etc., then I hope then you will find out paper 2 is easier as comparison to the paper 1. But trust me, paper 1 is very very easy, because here you have a particular animal diversity and it is quite interesting and it is not difficult at all. most of the students have phobia with the paper one. I do not know why you guys have a phobia. This paper is very easy, okay? So in paper one, we basically talk about the conventional geology, and in paper two, we are going to talk about the modern geology, clear? Now, going to start with the paper first, okay? So see, in paper first, you have two part. If I talk about the paper first have two part, the part A and the part B, okay? Part A have which subjects or which topics? Part A is like a heart of the paper one. Yes, the paper in one, in part A, you have phyla of the invertebrates, okay? And then you have the phyla of vertebrates and comparative anatomy. And what? The comparative anatomy, okay? So here we are going to talk about on this three particular topic. If I talk about the part B, what topics are included in your part B? So in part B, we have ecology, okay? We have economic geology, okay? Next we have ethology, okay? Next we have biostatic, and the last you have bioinstrumentation. Also see one point, the economic geology part, it is overlapping to your GS, okay? Because see, when you learned about the GS, about the like recent ongoing pollution and water pollution and green ozone layer, okay, greenhouse effects, and about the ozone layer, so yes, if you learn this thing in your GS, so you can add on this part, this particular part or this particular act in your answer writing. It make your answer authentic, because examiner ko lagega, yes, you are aware about the recent ongoing things, clear? So economics and ecology, it is important. In ecology, we are going to talk about the biogeomes of the world. We are going to talk about the cycle, nitrogen cycle, carbon cycle, phosphorus cycle. That is quite easy and also interesting. In ethology, we are going to talk about the animal behavior, okay? In biostatic and bioinstrumentation, yes, this is giving a little bit touch to your biotech part, clear? Next, in your paper 2, you have also two part. The one is your part A and the second is your part B, okay? In part A, you have cell biology, okay? Next, you have particular genetics, and next you have evolution and the systematic one, okay? Next, in part B, you have biochemistry, okay? And human physiology, which is very interesting, because in this unit, we are going to talk about the human physiology. We are going to talk about the human fluids, okay? Like RBC, plasma, then we will going to talk about the digestive system, neuron system, okay? In which we are going to talk about the synapse, how much synapse you have, okay? How synapse work, what are the types of neurotransmitters you have, okay? All the things. Human physiology, and the next you have developmental biology, okay? The next you have developmental biology. So this particular topics we are going to talk about. Now, what topics are very, very important? See, this topic are very, very important. By at any cost, you have to learn this topic like anything, okay? Ye topics aapki tips pe hone hi hone chahiye if you want your selection. एंड सी जूलॉजी में आपका सिलेक्शन कब मिलता है, व्हेन यू डू रिवीजन इन 3 sets. ओके, फर्स्ट और सेकंड रिवीजन इट्स लाइक योर कन्वेंशनल रिवीजन एंड द थर्ड रिवीजन इज योर फॉर द एग्जाम प्रैक्टिसिंग. ओके, लाइक जब आप किसी भी टेस्ट सीरीज में इन्वॉल्व करते हो तो थर्ड रिवीजन आपकी वो होती है. 3 sets ऑफ रिवीजन आप जब तक नहीं करोगे यू कांट लाइक आप अपने आप को इसी नहीं मान सकते, देन यू विल गोइंग टू गिव अचीव योर सिलेक्शन. ओके, विच टॉपिक्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, द वन इज योर ह्यूमन फिजियोलॉजी, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, योर सेल बायोलॉजी एंड जेनेटिक्स. ओके, सेल बायोलॉजी में आपको एक बहुत बड़ा मिथ होता है कि यस ये तो हम कर लेंगे. ट्रस्ट मी, अगर सेल बायोलॉजी में डायग्राम एंड एक्सप्लेनेशन सही से नहीं दिया तो 1-2 marks से ज़्यादा उम्मीद मत करना अपने एग्जामिनर से. ओके, हार्श है बट फैक्ट है. आपका एक ह्यूमन फिजियोलॉजी, सेल बायो, जेनेटिक्स एंड द पार्ट ए इन पेपर 1 विच आई टॉक यू कि दिस इज़ अ हार्ट ऑफ द पेपर 1, द फाइला ऑफ द वर्टिब्रेट्स, फाइला ऑफ द वर्टिब्रेट्स एंड द कंपैरेटिव एनाटॉमी. दिस 5 sections आर वेरी वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट. इसको तो आपको टिप्स पे होना ही चाहिए. ओके, नाउ हाउ यू राइट योर आंसर. ओके, आपको आंसर के लिए 3 skills डेट यू लर्न. ओके, वॉट आर द 3 skills डैट यू शुड बी लर्न. फर्स्ट योर स्ट्रक्चर. ओके, वेन एग्जामिनर आस्क यू अ क्वेश्चन एंड इन दिस आंसर यू थिंक लाइक दैट डायग्राम इज रिक्वायर्ड, सो वॉट यू ट्राई टू डू जस्ट एक्सप्लेन योर आंसर विद द हेल्प ऑफ डायग्राम. सो वेन यू ड्रॉ योर डायग्राम प्लीज लेबल इट वेरी नीट एंड क्लीन सो दैट एग्जामिनर एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट यू आर ट्राइंग टू एक्सप्लेन इन योर आंसर. ओके, डोंट लाइक दैट कि जैसे रफली डायग्राम बना दिया एंड उसे लेबल कर दिया, उसके बाद आप उम्मीद मत करो आपको नंबर देगा वो. नेक्स्ट होता है आपका, हमेशा आपने आंसर्स को फ्लो चार्ट्स में दो. ओके, लाइक कोई भी क्वेश्चन पूछा है तो उसको आपने एक सेंटेंस लिखा देन एक फ्लो चार्ट में करने का कोशिश करो. ओके, नेक्स्ट इफ़ यू थिंक कि आपको आंसर को डिफ्रेंशिएट करके लिखना है तो आप एक टैब्यूलेट फॉर्म में भी आंसर दे सकते हो. ओके, आप टेबुलेट फॉर्म में भी आंसर दे सकते हो एंड किसी आंसर में लिख रहा है आपको कि समेशन देना चाहिए हमें, सो ऑल्सो यू राइट दी समेशन ऑफ योर आंसर कि उसका रिजल्ट क्या है, डिसएडवांटेजेस क्या है, एडवांटेजेस क्या है. अगर लगता है कि आपसे पूछा है कि व्हाट इज ओजोन लेयर, इसके एडवांटेजेस डिसएडवांटेजेस, सो ओजोन लेयर के प्रोटेक्शन के लिए कोई भी लेटेस्ट अमेंडमेंट एक्ट चल रहा है उसे ऐड कर दो, उससे आपका आंसर विल बिकम अ मोर ऑथेंटिक एंड वो आपका दिखाता है कि यस आपने लेटेस्ट सर्वे को पढ़ के आए हो. क्लियर, सो आई होप दिस ट्रिक्स आर गोइंग टू बी हेल्पफुल फॉर यू. प्लीज फॉलो इट. ओके, इन नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी विल गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट सम अनदर टॉपिक. थैंक यू सो मच.